Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to show you a few examples for quests that I made with my own implementation of the plugin. So I already have some custom tasks for items that give you items or remove them, and I also have this one that lets you choose between one of the options, and I have this one also that modifies gold, so I use it here and in this branch. And what is this quest in particular doing? So it starts with this node. The NPC will give you three options. You can pick a sword, a potion, or gold. If you pick one of the items, it's going to let you choose if you want to keep it and end the quest, or if you want to give it back. And if you want to give it back, I'm gonna see which one of these quest tasks were completed, and I'm gonna remove the item that I gave you previously. And after that, the NPC will let you choose between a reward. And if you go for the gold, it's gonna give you 100 gold, and then of course it's gonna ask you if you want to keep the gold or return it. If you want to keep the gold, you're gonna remove a bit more gold than the one you got first, so you're gonna lose gold at the end, and it's gonna fail the quest. And if you return the gold, it's gonna take it back, and it will let you choose a reward that is the same one for the item. So I'm gonna resize this so you can see it while playing, and I'm gonna hit play. I disabled for this particular video the autosave, so every time I enter the game, it's gonna reset. So you can see this is the NPC, and this is the first node that you see here, and if I click it, this is completed and activated three options that you can see here. You can get the sword, the potion, or the gold. If any of these options completes, it's gonna disable the other ones so you don't see them anymore. So for the first run, I'm gonna go for the sword. You can see here, this one completed. If I open the inventory, you can see I have the sword, and this one are disabled. And now I am in this node. What do I have to do now? And it's gonna give you the option to end the quest or give the item back. So I'm gonna keep the item and I'm gonna complete the quest. And you see here the quest is completed, and if I open the inventory I still have it. I'm gonna remove it for now, and if we hit play again, remember this will reset the save game, so I have the quest again. And I'm gonna choose the potion now, so you can see here I got the same common node. What you want to do, I'm gonna show you the inventory. I have the potion now. I want to return the item now, so it's gonna go for this branch. Because I got the potion, it's gonna go for the middle, so I will return the item. And you can see this one completed, this completed, this completed. I don't have the potion anymore, and I have this task that will let me choose a reward, so I'm gonna click it, and you can see the reward here. This is the same tooltip for the item that you can see in the editor. This is because I'm using the same widget that in game. I'm gonna click the whatever reward, and I'm gonna see it here. And you can see now a new quest appeared. This is the second quest that I'm gonna show you in the video. For now I'm gonna shoot the stop, and this is going to reset. So let's play again. If I open the inventory, I still have this because the save for items is different. And now I'm gonna choose the gold. So what are you doing here? I want 100 gold. You can see for this this node in particular, these were optional links. So whatever, if you go for this branch or this one, it doesn't matter. Any of those will activate this node. But for this one, you will have you will need both of these nodes to be completed. This is going to complete instantly because this task will always complete for my implementation. So this will work. You can see here, if I show you the inventory, I start with 1 million, so you can see the 100 here that I got. And I am in this, this talk task. Oh, they are heavy. I'm gonna click it. And now you can see, I'm gonna move this one. You can see these two options that are active. You can keep the gold and fail the quest. And it's gonna remove a little bit more. So I'm gonna go for that. And you can see it remove the 500 and fail the quest. So if you fail the quest, it's gonna appear again in the quest inventory. So you can see it here again. I'm gonna adjust the reset, and now I'm gonna go for the branch that is not already, I haven't gone yet. So what are you doing here? I want the gold. Oh, they are heavy, and I will give the gold back. This is, so if you see, I have 700 because I was in 600 and I got 100. And now I will give the gold back. I am back to 600, and I have this common node that I used previously for the items, and it's gonna give me a reward again. So you can see again the reward popping, and I completed the quest. So this is the first quest, and the second one, let's stop the playing. The second one, let's find it, overview quest 2, is this one. So this one in particular has two NPCs. One is Cage, that is the first NPC for the first quest that I showed, and this one is the right NPC that you see in the map. So this one in particular, it should going to give some options, and then it's gonna send you to kill monster. You can start it from this NPC or this one. If you want to start for the Cage NPC, you will need to complete first the quest that we made. So if you go and hit play, and remember this is a reset save, you will not see it because you still have to complete this quest. And if you talk to the other NPC, let me open the editor again. You see this talk option. Oops, I remove the link. So you can see this one. Have you seen the spiders? It is. If I stop playing and remove this task and save the quest, I'm sure gonna save here. It's not really needed. But I'm gonna play, and you can see that I removed the condition for this node. So if you go and talk to Cage, you can see the bot of the quest that I made in this video. The spider are a problem is this start, and if I talk to the other NPC, you will see the other start. So I'm gonna go. Oops. I'm gonna go and give a go to the quest. So this is just the talk options. I'm gonna go fast for this one. Have you seen the spider on the north? You can see the three options. It's gonna send me to kill some spiders, and depending on the option I chose, it's gonna give me some gold. I'm gonna go with this one. This is the right one. This branch. And it's the one that pays more gold. Are you interested in insect? Yes, they are good, etc. Deal with them, and of course it's going to send you to kill some. So this is one task that is for my own system. It will send you to kill some spiders. I'm gonna need some spells here, so let's set those. Let's go with that. And here you can see in the UI there are a few things. You can see this quest mark. You can see also if I target them at the top, they are marked as quest objectives. So these are things that I made for my own game. I'm gonna kill the spider, you will see them updating here. So I got 4 of 5. I need to kill one more. And that completed. If I go back to the NPC, you can see that the condition went here because this is the part for Cage. And I started for the other NPC. So now this NPC wants to talk. I kill all the spider. This is the node. And because I have this this node completed, that is this one, I'm gonna go for the 200 gold. So if you go to the inventory, I have 600. I kill all the spiders, and I got 800. So that's the explanation for this video. I hope it's useful, and thanks for watching. Bye.